Hey guys, welcome to another episode of what we are now going to call Tiger Shorts, because Alex, whom I'm chatting with tonight, thought that would make a great name, again, because he's an alumnus, not a current student. So, Alex, welcome to our third episode. How are you?
Thank you so much. I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm good, man. Well, listen, if you could introduce yourself real quick. Your name, when you graduated from Hampden-Sydney, where you're from, and what you studied while you were at school.
Yeah, so my name's Alex Soulas, class of 2014 from Richmond, and I was a history major and a Spanish minor.
Awesome. Are you using either of those degrees proper these days?
Not at the moment, no.
Okay, got it. I was a religion major, so... people are always like, you're not a priest. I'm like, nope. Can you tell me a little bit about your college search, why you wound up choosing Hampden-Sydney in the end?
You know, it wasn't so much choosing Hampden-Sydney in the end as it was choosing Hampden-Sydney in the beginning. Okay. I actually did the early admission from the get-go. I just really loved everything about the school, the tradition, the brotherhood, and just the great reputation that Hampden-Sydney had in Richmond, in particular. The fact that I had a few friends also going to the school made it an easy choice for me.
That's awesome. Good stuff. Yeah, it was also an early decision app with this only school I applied to.
That's awesome.
It was a pretty easy choice. So tell me a little bit. I know you, you're a bit of an entrepreneur. You own your own business. Can you tell me a little bit about what you guys do and maybe a little history of the company?
Yeah, so my business is Crosswind Paddle Company. We're a small paddleboard tour operator and board sales rep here in Richmond. Paddleboarding is a huge passion of mine. Matter of fact, the first time I ever stood on a paddleboard was on Charles Grove Lake.
Nice.
The school had a couple boards that they rented out for exam week, and I went out there and tried one out, really thought it was relaxing and enjoyable. And that summer of my junior year, I actually ended up being an instructor for a business here in Richmond. So really fell in love with it, graduated in 14, and then in 2015 started Crosswind. Me and a buddy got together. We decided to make our own version of what we thought paddleboarding can be. And especially being here on the James River, it was really an easy, marriage to have water sports and the James River put together. So at Crosswind, we take people out on private tours and lessons, and we also host a annual charity race event for the James River Association every August. Mm-hmm. And we are also the authorized dealer for Michael Dulcey Paddleboards, which is a big outfit down in Norfolk. So,
okay.
Got a few facets going on with the company, and this is our fifth year in business, and it's been a fun ride.
That's awesome, man. You know, again, it's funny, back to that, you know, are you using your major, right? How has your education from Hampden-Sydney, the curriculum, you know, kind of the liberal arts, played into your success in owning your own business?
Well, you know, the liberal arts education at Hampden-Sydney really made me feel like I was never stuck in a box. It really kind of lets you think that you never have to be stuck in a mold. You know, history major, Spanish minor, you know, and I'm doing paddleboards. So it's one of those things where, you know, I never felt like I was just a history major or Spanish minor. And you can really follow your passion when you study liberal arts. And, you know, at Hampden-Sydney, it really helps you just open doors that somebody who might have gone to a larger school and just studied something very specifically for 4 years might not have. One of the biggest takeaways, I think, at least with owning a small business, and not just a small business, but a seasonal small business, mm-hmm. is relationships. And I learned at Hampden-Sydney that, you know, life really is relationships. And Hampden-Sydney helped me learn how to grow and foster and maintain those relationships that really help you get ahead in life and make things a lot easier and more productive than they would otherwise be.
Awesome. Yeah, I feel like just about every single one of our alumni has that story or that experience that they had with either the Brotherhood or our alumni network, one way or the other. Do you have one of your own? Can you talk a little bit about your experience with that bond that you had with the guys?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I mentioned the race event that we host every August, and you know, there's, believe it or not, there's a competitive side of paddleboard racing. And there's also just, you know, go out and enjoy yourself on the water type of paddling. So the Richmond Paddle Cup, as it's come to be known, has really kind of been a staple here. I've had friends from Hampden-Sydney drive as far down as from Baltimore and D.C., never stood on a paddleboard in their lives, but still signed up to donate to James River Association, drove down, got on a board, and went out in the water and did the course just simply to support me and to support Crosswind. So, you know, just stuff like that is just like, wow. I mean, you know, not only did he drive 2.5-3 hours, he's never been on a board before and he's out here supporting me. That's really what the Hampden-Sydney bond and brotherhood is really about.
For sure, man. Were you in a fraternity in Hampden-Sydney?
I was in Sigma Chi.
Okay, got it. Yeah, I was a Lambda Chi. My grandfather was actually a Sigma Chi at Hampden-Sydney.
Good man.
Yeah, I guess graduated over 60 years ago now, which is kind of wild. Coming up on 70 years, I guess. Wow. Cool, man. Well, listen, do you have any, obviously the decision to come to Hampden-Sydney was an easy one for you. What advice would you give to that student who maybe hasn't figured it out yet and is still deciding between, you know, this school in Hampden-Sydney or these schools in Hampden-Sydney?
Well, you know, it really comes down to preference, but I don't know if this was an old bumper sticker or just an old saying, but I remember when I was in high school and I was making this choice, it was, the saying was, if you see a car drive by with a UVA sticker or a South Carolina sticker, you think, oh, there's another fan. But if you see a car drive by and it's got a Hampden-Sydney sticker, you think, I probably know him. And that ended up being the most honest and real thing ever, because, you know, it's such a tight-knit community, and it just, that means so much more once you're experiencing it and once you're living it and once you have gone through it. You know, the college experience at Hampden-Sydney, it really is about having a tight-knit family, and everyone's close with each other. You can rely on anyone if you're ever down or need some help, and it just opens doors again with the relationships that you build at such a small school like Hampden-Sydney, that, you know, you go to a school with 35,000 people, might not always be the same way.
Right. Awesome. Good deal, man. Well, I really appreciate you taking the time out of your day to chat. I know it's there's no rest these days, especially as a small business owner. But thank you again for your time, and go Tigers.
Great. Thanks a lot, Marshall. Take care.
Yeah, man. You too.